Good morning, children. Myself, Ashima Madam. Starting with the second online lecture for subject biology. So you all know, children, that in the last lecture, we started with chapter 8, respiration and circulation, where we started with the definition of respiration. We have seen the reaction, the gaseous exchange which takes place through the respiratory surfaces in plants and in animals. Today we are going to start with the human respiratory system. Children, human respiratory system, which is an organ system responsible for the conduction of the life process respiration, comprises of upper respiratory system and lower respiratory system. Our respiratory system comprises of, or I can say even, it is divided into two parts, upper respiratory system and the lower respiratory system. Let's see, upper respiratory system of human being comprises of external nares, also called as nostrils, the two small openings used for inhaling and exhaling of air, nasal cavities, internal nares, nasopharynx, nose, and the throat. Once again, upper respiratory system comprises of external nares or nostrils, nasal cavities, or I can even say nasal chamber, internal nares, nasopharynx, nose, and the throat. Whereas lower respiratory system comprising of larynx, which is the sound box, trachea, the windpipe, bronchi, bronchioles, and a pair of lungs, which serves as the main respiratory organ of the human respiratory system. Once again, children, lower respiratory system starts with or comprises of larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, and lungs. Children, just view the diagram of human respiratory system. If you see the diagram, the respiratory system of human being starts with the nostril, that is a pair of small openings, which leads to this chamber, which is called as nasal chamber. This nasal chamber ends on pharynx. This pharynx region extends till this area, and then it leads to larynx or the sound box. So, human respiratory system starts with the nostrils, a pair of small openings, leading to nasal chamber, which leads to pharynx, a common passage for the entrance of, or for the passage of both food and air, which in turn leads to larynx, the sound box, from where the sound comes. Larynx leads to windpipe, that is trachea. This trachea ends on bronchus. Children, this part is the bronchus. It is situated in the mid of the thoracic cavity, that is the chest cavity. Bronchus then divides into two small branches. Each one is called as bronchi. Here, children, these two branches, the one going towards the left side is the left bronchi, and the one entering into the right lung is the right bronchi. Moment these two bronchi enters into the lungs, you can see the scenario very well seen in the right lung. The bronchi divides and redivides and redivides to form fine branches which are called as bronchioles. Children, these bronchioles then terminates into air sacs, which looks like bunch of grapes clustered together, called as alveoli of the lungs. So, we have seen that the human respiratory system starts with the nostrils, leading to the nasal chamber, then to the pharynx, larynx, trachea, that's the windpipe, bronchus, left and the right bronchi, entering into the left and the right lungs, very well situated in the thoracic cavity, one on either side of the heart. Lungs, which is protected by ribs. Children, you can see ribs over here. And the two spongy lungs rest on a membrane, which even is an important part and parcel of our respiratory system, that's the diaphragm. Let us now study all these parts in detail, one by one. Starting with the nose, which is an important sense organ, also an important part and parcel of our upper respiratory system. Children, nose has a pair of small openings called as external nares, or also called as nostrils. The two small openings through which air is inhaled and it is exhaled out. Next, the nose, which starts with the opening nostrils. So here you can explain nostrils as a pair of small openings called as external nares or nostrils, and it leads to the nasal cavities. Next, we'll see the nasal cavities. Now children, the nasal cavity is divided into right and left nasal chamber. The entire cavity is divided into two chambers, right and left nasal chamber, by a flexible mesthmoid cartilage. When you hold your nose and just twist it, it's very flexible. It is flexible, children, because of this mesthmoid cartilage, which divides the nasal cavity into right and left nasal chamber. Next, children, nasal chamber. The entire nasal chamber is divided into three regions: anterior vestibules, mid respiratory part, also called as conditioner, and olfactory or sensory chamber. So, our nasal chamber, which is divided into right part and also left nasal chamber, in turn has three regions: anterior vestibules, mid respiratory part or conditioner, and last, olfactory or sensory chamber. Let us now study, children, each and every part of the nasal chamber in detail, starting with vestibules. It is the proximal part of the nasal chamber. I can even say the anterior part of the nasal chamber. It has very fine hairs for filtering the air which enters through the nostrils. At the same time, these hair traps the dust particle which is inhaled. So, vestibules, which serves as the proximal or the anterior part of the nasal chamber, has hair for filtration of air and also for trapping the dust particles which are inhaled. Moving on to the second, or I can say the mid region of the nasal chamber, that is respiratory part, also called as conditioner. This is the middle thin walled region, highly vascular in nature. That is, this mid region is richly supplied with the blood vessels. And children, this region warms up and moistens up the inhaled air. You know very well, children, that the air that we breathe from the surrounding is very dry. If you inhale such dry air, it will cause damage to our system, which is very tender, very delicate. So the air has to be moistened up. At the same time, the temperature of the outside air is different. So when the air enters, or when we breathe in the air, the temperature of the air should match along with the normal body temperature. So the respiratory part, or the conditioner, even warms up the inhaled air. Last, the part which is present is the olfactory, or the sensory chamber. Olfactory or sensory chamber is the uppermost part, children, which is lined by olfactory epithelium. And this epithelium helps to detect the smell. You know very well, as we started with the nose, very first I have stated that it's an important sense organ which is used for smelling the things around. You know very well, children, that if you're sitting in a room and at some distance a bottle of perfume is broken down, immediately our nose, from a far off distance, senses out the smell and we start saying, "Arey, perfume ka bottle toota hai, lagta hai, khushbu aa rahi hai." Also, sometimes when you're sitting in the bedroom and you're involved, you're indulged in a family talk, immediately one person runs towards the kitchen, sensing the smell of the milk which is burning in the kitchen. So, this olfactory or the sensory chamber, children, helps for detection of smell. Moving on to pharynx, a chamber, a common chamber for the passage of both food and air. And you know, children, this is a part which is common between human digestive system and human respiratory system. So children, pharynx is divided in turn into three regions: nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. Pharynx is divided into three regions: nasopharynx, oropharynx and laryngopharynx. If you see the first part of it, nasopharynx, it is the uppermost part from the nasal chamber. Moving on to oropharynx, which serves as a common chamber for the passage of both food and air. And finally, oropharynx ends on laryngopharynx. Children, this part, pharynx, has a pair of lymphoid organs called as tonsils. You might have heard that many people, they suffer from the problem of tonsils whenever they eat anything cold or anything sour. They start getting infections in their tonsils. Yes, I'm talking about the same lymphoid organ, so-called tonsils, present in the pharynx region. Here, tonsils. You know, children, that pharynx leads to larynx. We all have witnessed that in the diagram of human respiratory system. Here, children, larynx is the organ of phonation. An organ which produces the sound. Therefore, it is also called as sound box or Adam's apple. It contains a pair of vocal cords. A pair of elastic cords which vibrates and produces the sound, just like that of a sitar or a guitar. When you pluck the strings of sitar or guitar, the strings vibrates and produces the sound. In the similar manner, when the air passes through the larynx, the vocal cord vibrates and produces the sound. Children, larynx extends from the laryngopharynx, hyoid bone, till the trachea, which is the windpipe. It is a hollow tubular structure made up of cartilage plate, held by membranes and muscles. And this very important organ, so-called larynx, is protected by a flap-like structure, children, called as epiglottis. Vocal cord produces the sound, and the organ larynx is protected by a flap-like structure called as epiglottis. You know, children, जब भी हम बैठकर खाना खाते हैं और खाना खाते वक्त जोर जोर से हंसी मजाक या बातचीत चलती है तो अचानक यकायक यू गेट अ जर्क, एक ठसका सा लगता है एंड इट इज अनटॉलरेबल. यू नो वॉट एग्जैक्टली हैपन्स? द फूड which has to pass through the pharynx into the food pipe, that is esophagus, enters into the trachea, that's the windpipe, due to the mismanagement of this flap called as epiglottis. आपने कभी experience किया होगा जब कभी भी ये situation आती है, you get immediate jerks, your throat start burning, literally you have to open your mouth under the air to give a soothing feeling to the throat. So once again, children, before we proceed to the next part, larynx, which is the organ of phonation, also called as the sound box or Adam's apple, it contains a pair of vocal cord which vibrates and produces the sound. It extends from laryngopharynx, hyoid bone, till the trachea, that's the windpipe. And overall, if you see, it's a hollow tubular structure made up of cartilage plate held by membranes and muscles. And children, larynx is guarded by a flap-like or a door-like structure which is called as epiglottis. Let's view the diagram of larynx. See children, here the entire organ is guarded by a flap-like epiglottis, has a hyoid bone, thyroid membrane, thyroid cartilage, and the larynx ends up on trachea. So this hollow tubular structure is guarded by epiglottis, supported by membranes and muscles. Children, now let's start with trachea, which is the windpipe. It is a long tube which is 10 to 12 centimeter in length. It runs through the neck in front of esophagus, which is the food pipe. Yani ki aapke gale mein pehle windpipe hota hai aur uske niche food pipe hota hai, which is esophagus. So it runs through the neck in front of the esophagus and extends up to the middle of thoracic cavity. That's a chest cavity, children. And this tubular windpipe is kept distended. It is kept intact in position by 16 to 20 C-shaped cartilage. The windpipe is kept distended by 16 to 20 C-shaped cartilage. And internally, trachea is lined by ciliated, pseudostratified epithelium along with the mucus gland. ये जो हमारा windpipe है, ये जो हमारी सांस की नली है, जिसको हम trachea बोलते हैं, internally it is having small, very delicate hair-like structure called as cilia. So internally it is lined by ciliated, pseudo-stratified epithelium, an epithelial membrane which has thin cilia, mucus gland to keep it moist. Now this inner lining, children, traps the unwanted particles entering into the lungs. The ciliated pseudo-stratified epithelium provided with the mucus gland, which serves as the internal lining of the trachea, traps the unwanted particles which enters into the lungs. Now we are ending up the respiratory system with the main respiratory organs. As you have seen beautifully in the diagram, a pair of lungs which serves as the main respiratory organ of the human being. These spongy, elastic, pinkish organ is present one on either side of the heart, children, in the thoracic cavity. A pair of lungs which is very spongy, elastic in nature, pinkish in color, is present one on either side of the heart in the thoracic cavity. And as you all know that every vital organ of our body is protected by a membrane. You might have studied that the brain is protected by meninges. Heart is protected by pericardial membrane called as pericardium. In the similar manner, these two tender, very vital organ, which plays a very crucial role in the respiration, is protected by a double membrane which is called as pleura. The outer membrane is called as parietal membrane and the inner membrane is called as visceral membrane. Children, between the two pleura, there is a cavity called as pleural cavity. And this pleural cavity is filled up with a lubricating fluid called as pleural fluid. As you all know, children, that we have a pair of lungs which serves as the respiratory organ. So the right lung is larger and is divided into three lobes, whereas the left lung is smaller in size and is divided into only two lobes. We know very well, children, that heart is also tilted towards the left side. So you have beautifully witnessed in the diagram of human respiratory system that the right lung is larger and the left lung is smaller. Each lung has fine branches called as bronchioles. Or I can even say, children, that each bronchi, after entering into the lungs of its own side, divides and redivides into fine branches called as bronchioles. The bronchi, after entering into the lungs, divides into primary bronchioles, secondary bronchioles, again divides into tertiary bronchioles, and finally ends into respiratory bronchioles. Children, these respiratory bronchioles opens up into the air spaces or the air sacs, which is called as alveoli of the lungs. So each lung has bronchioles terminating into air sacs called as alveoli of the lungs. So, lungs, which is internally provided with millions of alveoli or the air sacs, which looks like bunch of grapes, called as alveoli of the lungs. They are thin, membranous, and is richly supplied with the blood vessels and serves as the site for the exchange of gases. Finally, children, as you have witnessed in the diagram, that the entire human respiratory system, or I can even say a pair of spongy lungs, settles on a thin membrane called as diaphragm. A membrane which even serves as a partition membrane for the thoracic cavity and the abdominal cavity, and even plays an important role in the inhalation and exhalation of the air. So, don't forget, children, that diaphragm and even ribs, don't forget the ribs, children, which protects the lungs, forms the ribs cage, because as we have seen earlier, that every tender organ, every vital organ is naturally protected by very first membrane, and then in turn provided by, it is protected by the endoskeleton. And for lungs, the protection is provided by ribs. As we have seen, our brain is protected by cranium. That's the skull. So children, today we have studied about one of the most important system, organ system of our body, that is human respiratory system. I will end up the session today, and in the next session we'll proceed on with this chapter. Thank you, children.